This is Spine Cadaver. I'm standing on the right side, and the camera person is also on the right side. So we have completely removed the small intestine from its attachment to the posterior abdominal wall. The small intestine is composed of the jejunum proximal 2/5 and the ileum terminal 3/5. This is about 6 to 7 meters long. When we talk of the small intestine, we do not include the duodenum in that. Just to bring up to speed, the small intestine is a derivative of the midgut. So therefore, all these blood vessels that we see in the mesentery of the small intestine, that is the jejunal arteries and the ileal arteries, are all branches of the superior mesenteric artery. We have completely removed all the contents of the abdomen, and we can see the blood vessels here. This artery that I have lifted up here, this is the superior mesenteric artery. This is the artery of the midgut, and the branches that we can see here, these are all the colic arteries. And the branches that we can see coming out in the terminal end, these are some of the jejunal and the ileal arteries. There are hundreds of them which supply the midgut. And this artery that we see here, this is the inferior mesenteric artery, which is the artery of the hindgut. The jejunal and the ileal arteries, they supply the small intestine, they are the arteries of the midgut. Let us take a quick look at the parts of the jejunum and how they compare with the ileum. If you take a look at the jejunum here, you find that it is thick, it is fleshy, and it is pink in color. In contrast, if you were to take up a segment of the ileum, which is located in the terminal part, we notice that it is thin, pale. So this is the ileum. That is the first important difference between the jejunum and the ileum. Now let's take a look at the mesentery. I'm holding up a loop of the jejunum, and we can see that the mesentery has got fat, but not as much as will be present in the ileum. In contrast, ileum fat is extremely dense, it's very thick, and the fat, mesenteric fat, is encroaching onto the mesenteric side of the ileum. So that is the second difference. The third difference, we have opened up the leaves of the mesentery to show you the blood vessels. And if you were to look very closely in the jejunum, this is the blood vessel pattern. We can see the vascular arcade here. There's only one series of arcade, maximum two series of arcades. And then from the arcades, we have these vessels running. These are referred to as the vasa recta. So therefore, there are very few vascular arcades, and the vasa recta are long, which run to the mesenteric side of the intestine. In contrast, we have opened up the leaves of the mesentery of a segment of the ileum. And again, if you were to look closely, we find a considerable difference. We find that the vascular arcades are many. We have one series of arcades here, one here, one here, one here. And therefore, there are many series of arcades, and the vasa recta are small, and they go directly to the mesenteric side of the intestine. So these are the vasa recta, which are very small. So in a nutshell, in an ileum, vascular arcades are many, and the vasa recta are small. Now we have opened up a segment of the jejunum, and we can see a segment of the jejunum here. We can see that the mucosal folds are very prominent, dense, and big. These mucosal folds are called plicae circularis or the valvulae conniventes. These are the ones which give the feathery appearance in a barium meal follow-through. This is the barium meal follow-through to show this feathery appearance of the mucosal pattern of the small intestine proximal part. In contrast, when we open up a segment of the ileum, which we have done here, we see that the ileum is smooth. The mucosal folds are almost non-existent. This is the one which has been described by Wagenstein as characterless when we see a barium meal follow through. Not seen in this dissection, but if you were to take a microscopic view of the submucosa of the ileum, you'll find multiple collections of lymphoid tissue which are referred to as Peyer's patches, while these Peyer's patches will be absent in the jejunum. So these are the important differences between the jejunum and the ileum, and they help us during surgery. Now let me mention a few important clinical correlations. This, what you see, is the mesentery. And the root of the mesentery is only 45 centimeters extending obliquely from the tip of the transverse process of the L2 vertebra on the left side to the upper end of the sacroiliac on the right side. So this is the length of the mesentery. And from a 45 centimeter mesenteric attachment, 6 to 7 meters of small intestine are coiled inside the abdomen. Therefore, the small intestine can undergo obstruction, it can undergo ischemic necrosis, especially the ileum, because of its relatively lack of blood supply. When we have a pathology of the small intestine, we have to do what is known as resection anastomosis. And I have demonstrated the principle of the resection anastomosis in one segment here. Suppose this segment of the small intestine has become necrosed and we have to resect this. First thing what we do is we make a V-shaped incision on the mesentery, from the mesenteric side or to the root of the mesentery. And then we clamp and ligate the blood vessels in sections all the way from the mesenteric side to the root of the mesentery on both the ends. And then we clamp this segment of the intestine which has become gangrenous. We remove it, and then we anastomose this end with this end, end-to-end anastomosis, by means of staples or by sutures, whichever is available. So this is the principle of resection and end-to-end anastomosis of the small intestine. Now let me demonstrate yet another procedure that we do in the small intestine, especially with regard to the terminal ileum, and that is called ileostomy. If for some reason we have had to remove the colon and we have to bring out a loop of ileum out to the abdominal wall and connect it to a bag, that is called ileostomy. Here the skin has been removed, but imagine the skin was present. We first make an opening in the skin. A disc-shaped portion of the skin is removed in the region of the right iliac fossa. Then a disc-shaped portion of the external oblique aponeurosis is removed and the internal oblique aponeurosis. And through this opening, we pull out a segment of the terminal ileum which is exposed. And that is what we are doing right now. We catch hold of it with a gentle artery forceps and pull it out from here. And then we turn it out and we suture the walls of the intestine to the skin like this. This is called ileostomy. And this projection, about 1 inch projection that we see here, is called the ileostomy spout. This is connected to an ileostomy bag which collects the fecal matter. So this is the principle and the principle of technique of ileostomy. So these are two commonly performed procedures in the small intestine that I wanted to demonstrate to all of you. Thank you very much for watching. Dr. Sanjay Sanya signing out. Please like and subscribe. If you have any questions or comments, please put them in the comment section below. Have a nice day.